Madison Libraries, finding the music for tonight's event. I was so genuinely surprised by the sheer variety of music I found. From music of the Holocaust, we have tragic songs about children, to light-hearted Weimar-era highway numbers written here in the chat. From satirical operas about totalitarianism to frenetic string trios. And what the variety of that program really shows is the power that the arts can have in times of oppression. Tonight's program commemorates the millions of lives that were taken in the Holocaust. It also seeks to recover the voices of those that were cruelly silenced during their lives and to resurrect them through music. To open tonight's event is a setting of Anima Amin written by Rabbi David Asher Ostrad. The text of Anima Amin is a prayer about firm belief, but the setting was written in the Warsaw Ghetto and became an anthem of resistance through faith and hope in the darkest times. According to some accounts, the setting of Anima Amin was sung by thousands of Jews as they were marched to the gas chambers. And it remains a powerful sentiment against the cruelest of people.
Oh, Ja, denn weißt du, der Herr, Thank you. Später mich nach Hause über die Sachen, die täglich mir so oft passieren. Die Opfer, die Löcher, die Schüchen, die Dächer, ich kann das aber gar nicht mehr genieren. Ich finde es entsetzlich, wenn jemand so plötzlich das für mich und redet, war das los. Die Schwache damit wollte nicht mit sammeln, es kann halt niemand deuten, wenn auch ein Mann muss. Ja, das geht nicht, so mancher, es versteht nicht, ich komme zu und renne mich und sage,
Herbert Hill, which is the Center for Jewish Student Life here on the campus, is proud to co-sponsor this important and powerful concert in recognition of Yom HaShoah. Holocaust Remembrance Day, the full Hebrew name of which is Yom HaZikaron LaShoah VaLegevura, literally the day of the remembrance of the Holocaust and of the heroism, became an official legal holiday in Israel in 1953 and is now observed by Jews throughout the world. On this day, we remember Nazi Germany's incomprehensible and systematic destruction of Jewish life. We think of the 6 million Jews who were tortured, starved, and exterminated in ways more cruel and inhumane than we can ever understand. Although we cannot grasp what the number 6 million murdered human beings means, and these human beings accounted for 1/3 of the world's Jewry at the time, we hope that by putting their music to life tonight, we are able to celebrate the lives that they did lead. They were so much more than numbers on the pages of a history book or the numbers that were tattooed onto their arms. They were full, imaginative, infinite human beings. Thank you for joining us tonight in celebrating their resilience and their creativity. Indeed, the second part of this title of Holocaust Remembrance Day, the Legevura and the heroism, reminds us that these people were so much more than just victims of the Holocaust. They resisted both through literal uprisings and by continuing to compose music that brings deep beauty into this world. In Israel, sirens blast to interrupt the day in honor of Yom HaShoah, a small reminder of the way in which violent and horrific anti-Semitism tore through the fabric of the Jewish people. These sirens harken back to the Jewish shofar, a ram's horn that we use to mark several holidays throughout the year. I personally am reminded of one of my favorite poems that is included side-by-side traditional liturgy in Mishkan Tefillah, the prayer book that I use. A reflection on the Amidah prayer beseeches God to ruffle us from our complacency. I hope that the music that we share with you all tonight can act as a siren or as a shofar, albeit a very beautiful one, that can also ruffle us all from our complacency. Our complacency of considering the Holocaust through grand numbers and not through individual lives stolen, and also our complacency in the face of rising anti-Semitism and bigotry of all kinds today. Please enjoy the rest of this evening's program. It is a joy and a privilege to share it all with you tonight. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much once again for coming from behind barbed wire, a Holocaust Remembrance Concert. For this final number, I'd like to invite all of the vocalists on stage for the Partisans Hymn. This is an international theme of Holocaust resistance. This is a melody written during the Warsaw Ghetto Uprising, and I had the privilege of singing it for hundreds of Holocaust survivors, and all of them still knew every word, which will always stick with me. It's an incredibly powerful song about survival and strength in the darkest of times.